Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.
Today's episode of The Mike O'Mara Show is brought to you by our bonus packages. Please go to MikeO'MaraShow.com and click on the bonus banner. You'll get access to all of our bonus content, and even better, you'll be helping out TMOS. So please, quit sucking, and we thank you.
Available on demand every day in iTunes and the Google Play Store and around the world on MikeO'MaraShow.com. What more can we do for you? It's The Mike O'Mara Show.
Nothing is working on my computer today. I'm trying, but nothing is working.
Is that the one that you went in for repair, or is it another one?
I am so ready to move to a facility where I can actually function. You know, I'm really ready for that. I think it's important.
Is it a little sad to every morning go to an empty house?
Yeah. It reminds me of what a terrible situation I'm in. But you know what? It's frustrating, but at the same time, in order for me to use a computer,
right.
I use two computers, one for the show and one for me that has everything on it that preps the show. And then there's running the show. And in order for me to like discuss something online or on the internet, I have to move the computer over and literally sit it on top of my other computer.
I know. I see
so
you do.
So quite often I'll forget that I've done that. And I'll be trying to control the main show computer with the computer that's on top of it. And it's not working. And I get confused because I'm such a stupid idiot.
You're not stupid.
Finally I realize that I'm trying to simply start the show timer and I get frustrated because nothing is working. And then I realize I'm such an idiot that I've been typing on the wrong thing, and that is frustrating for me. And
you see,
I'm also
maybe a
little tired of the reverb as well.
I think it gives you a very distinct sound and makes the show sound big. But also, you're not an idiot as much as you have been forced to do what you need to do in a less than ideal situation.
Well, it's just been a week. It's been a week.
I know.
Tell you that.
I know.
It's been one of those weeks, and I have to ask, what is the status of my furniture? Is it going to be shipped?
Yes, we have a quote from another firm that is much more reasonable. That when we get offline, we'll have you approve it, and I will drop it off for shipping today.
All right, so you're talking cryptically. You can talk frankly with me. When you're talking much more reasonable, how many dollars reasonable are we talking?
I think like this many. Yeah, it's still a lot because it's a big thing.
It's cheaper for me to get a brand new one.
Well, no, it's not. No, because you're looking at something like $2,000.
You still think
shipping?
It's
shipping, yeah.
Ridiculous.
Oh, it's less than $600. Not bad freight.
Well, then you didn't have that right.
Yeah, I did. I said it's about $500.
I said, what is the difference?
Oh, okay. Well,
I was asking. You're such a mallet head sometimes communicating.
Yeah, no,
you.
You know, you're fussy.
No, I mean, I just said
you're fussy
what is the,
and
I
you're
was
tired.
Trying to,
and
no,
I just want to say it's $500.
No, you're an idiot sometimes.
Well,
I said, what is
all?
The difference? We had $13 for ship, $1,300 for shipping.
Yes.
Right. And I said, what is the difference? And you put $500.
All right.
So what is $1,300 minus $500?
It is $800, and that's
right.
More
and
than...
I said $800 would be a lot for shipping. And then
right.
You said, no, you said $500. That is not reasonable. That is not unreasonable.
That's not unreasonable. Right.
That's where I got confused. And then
right.
You blame me for being fussy
tired. No.
I have 9 hours of sleep.
Nobody's
under my belt.
Fussy baby today. It's
you were
exciting.
Late getting in. And,
no, I wasn't.
And
I was on time.
I was in the studio waiting for 10 minutes for you to check in. And then you roll in 2 minutes before the show is going to start. And you say, I was getting tea.
I was
so
getting a cup of tea.
That's what I'm frustrated about.
We were all set, and I'm sorry about that.
I remember in the days long ago when there would be a radio show done, and we would all be ready.
Of
we
course,
would be at
on
the studio
time.
2 hours before
two
the
hours.
Show would start.
Yes.
With us, it's labada-dabada-dabada.
It's,
so
an, early start to, it's
in.
An early start today.
I note the text.
To be fair.
Okay.
Right.
All right. Anyone at work. The show was scheduled to start at 8:40.
That is at 8:44 as we speak.
At 8:35, I write, is anyone at work? And then Pony responds, I'm here.
Yeah. Not we're here.
No.
I'm here.
And I said, I've been checking because I just wanted to see what was going on.
Okay. Well, we were here. I apologize I didn't notify you, but
we were
all set. And we were
What time did you walk into the building?
Be honest.
8:10 today, I think.
8:10?
Pony, yeah. Is he telling the truth?
Pony, was he here at 8:10? Yes or no?
He was.
He said he was.
Yeah, because I know that Waze had me arriving here at 8:05.
Were you dropping a deuce?
No. I didn't even, you know what? I normally take a leak before I come into the studio, but I came directly to the studio today.
Just going to go for point of reference here. I'm just going to go back and
and looked. Okay. All right. So.
The texts are important.
They are.
They're actually in this modern age.
Now the times
age,
are getting fluid.
And no, in this modern age, mm-hmm. a text is everything.
Yes.
Because it gives you a timestamp and when things happened.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Like you saw my response.
What?
Your
response
the group
I don't care about. Oh. Almost there.
I said no. I said answer the man.
Yeah. But that's
someone answer the man. Don't just
Tony,
sit there and
what
stare
time were you here?
I was here at, I think, about 7:40.
Yeah, he gets here early.
He does.
No claps.
Why not?
What?
Because there's still something wrong every time we start. So it's not efficient. It's not an efficient 7:40 arrival. It's simply right. just to get out of traffic.
Really?
Yes.
Really? But see, you can't blame me for being cranky and tired when
I'm not blaming
tired.
You. I got nothing
no,
on.
No, I'm talking about Rob. I'm getting back to Rob.
No, I'm so, you know, it's just... I miscommunicated.
I think
the Desjardins.
You might be projecting onto me something you may be suffering from yourself. How much sleep did you get, require last night?
Well, I required a lot, but I got about 5 hours.
Oh no!
There we are.
But you know,
I'm tired and cranky. I'm the tired
well,
and
no,
cranky.
But
one.
You know what? You know me. I'm not a cranky guy.
What happened,
yes,
though?
Yes, you are.
What?
Inside you are. Inside right now you're going,
tormented?
Shut the F up, Mike.
There's an angry bear.
No. We were out because of the Mr. Tusk Award contest.
You had an event for your son's
And then
school.
I had to come back and finish some stuff up, and I rise very early, so I did not get a lot of sleep.
Mr. Tusk Aurora?
Yes, that's his
Would
high school.
Would you describe yourself this morning as a little cranky?
No, not at all. I'm excited about the shows today. We've got fun stuff. Can't wait for the bonus show.
Did Mr. Tusk Aurora go sideways?
I don't understand.
Like, did something go wrong at Mr. Tusk Aurora?
No.
Well, he's going to have an update on Mr. Tusk. We did do that. You didn't come to rehearsal, but we did do that.
Oh, I'm sorry.
We will be discussing that. And
he left yesterday with joy. He was joyful when he left yesterday.
But you will be happy to know that your Oscars take today will be preempted. It's going to be preempted when we are joined. At least that's what I'm told. That'll be an adventure, like it always is. From Angie Goff at
Woo!
The Super Bowl.
Yeah,
Angie
Miami
Goff will
all
be
week.
Checking in.
Getting national today. Coverage.
Oh, and my wife's going.
Okay, oh, that's good. Good.
Well, maybe she doesn't know there's an early start either, Mike.
Right, let me see. Hi, this sweetie. You're on the air. We're taping.
Oh, do you need water?
I do. I have an empty house with no vessels. Oh, that's sweet of you.
So
thank
nice.
You very much.
From another
Oh, and
location.
I have to talk, Carla, before we start, because the guys don't even know anything about this. Tell us about our new, how do you like our brand new water filter?
I don't know.
You don't like it. You don't like
it's
it.
It's a lot of work. It's
like
a lot of work, Carl. I know.
It's a lot of work. I'll see you later. Bye.
That was a very genuine, I don't know.
I bought a Berkey water filter, which is supposed to be the gold standard.
How do we spell Berkey?
Berkey.
Okay.
Do you boil it?
It is a water filtration unit that you can actually take river water or pond water and it will purify it.
Oh.
It is so efficient that it takes the food coloring out of water.
Okay,
no kidding. Like if you were to run Kool-Aid, a batch of Kool-Aid.
If you ran water and you put like green food coloring it would take it out of the water.
You're saying if I put a cup of the Chesapeake Bay's finest inside your filter,
no,
I'll have regular
salt water.
Brackish water. You can't do brackish water.
Can't do salt water. I'm saying
can't
if
you
took
drink
any fresh,
river water?
If you took a freshwater source and you put it in there, it would make it potable.
So you know what? Is this like? Is this made for like the survivors of the apocalypse?
No, it's simply a it's a water. It's like you get a water filter for your faucet.
Okay.
But I use tap water, and I don't trust the water.
Rube alert.
Why?
I'm not a
because
rube.
Because you would drink fresh water from a stream any day. That's clean water.
No. There are contaminants in runoff and things. I'm not talking about like a mountain spring, Oscar.
Oh.
I'm talking about, say, like, the Occoquan.
It's like maybe,
okay?
Mike.
You wouldn't want to go get a big glass full of Occoquan water, would you?
Like maybe something about a mile downstream from the Dow Corporation.
Something that might make you all of a sudden. Oh, by the way,
is the Potomac considered?
I hope I'm not. I'm all over the place, but I hope I'm not speaking out of school. You know how you guys want me to watch Curb Your Enthusiasm?
Yes, yes, of course.
So I watched Curb Your Enthusiasm, and the Trump hat thing is pretty goddamn funny.
The first episode?
That he's wearing the Trump hat.
So great.
Does the Jeff guy, whoever...
Jeff Garland, his manager?
Yeah.
So he got something wrong with his mouth?
Well, he had a stroke a few years ago, Mike.
Oh, he did?
Yeah.
Is that what it is?
Working actor, yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
All right.
Because he's also on the Goldbergs. He's a very funny man.
Looks like he like had something chewing on his...
Yeah, couldn't be a nerve.
And how great...
loosened up yet.
How great is Richard Lewis?
Richard Lewis looks like...
He
does not look well.
Well, he looked horrible when we met him 10 years ago.
I know.
Like pasty death.
Richard Lewis disturbs me when I see him.
I like seeing him because he's an actor that says, F it, we're all old on this show. Let's just go.
I know.
But it's so funny. It's a very old show. No, it's not.
I would say it's a mass appeal show, but everybody on the show character-wise is a little older.
Yeah.
I was with you. And was enjoying, but I'm sorry, Larry having sex with his ex-wife, that doesn't do it for me.
Well, he writes...
The talcum powder, it's disgusting.
You know that part, gross. He has to write that for himself.
Yes, of course
The way Seinfeld
does.
Always had a beautiful girlfriend.
Right, it's
right?
gross.
Yeah.
It's totally
perfect
gross.
Perfect girlfriend.
Mm-hmm. You cannot make Larry David, 90-year-old Larry David, a sexual object. You can't put him in sexy. I know you guys are big fans of the show. Please tell me I'm correct. I'm 60. I don't think
Mike,
of myself in
you
those
You just
terms
had a baby.
Anymore.
You're a sexual being.
You are.
Oh, God. But I just think.
Technically, that with the math would add up.
That was so. It's
ask
so
I actually,
nasty.
I have a theory on it.
She comes over for a booty call because he's such a sex machine.
Wait a second.
I have a theory.
You have a gorgeous wife.
I know I have a gorgeous wife, but
you
I don't.
You are basically
do you
Larry
think of yourself,
David's age.
Do you think of yourself as a sexually charged individual?
No. No, I got no lead in my pencil. It's broken.
No, yeah.
I use that on a regular pencil.
It's my 30.
I have
a mechanical pencil,
and it keeps just breaking off.
Exactly.
And break it off.
And the eraser's gone.
Yeah.
I've felt that way since my 30s. I have felt
you
that way since
You just had a baby. 30s. Come on.
I didn't have a baby 6 years ago. I had a baby.
That's still, but Mike, my theory on Larry David as a sexual being.
Yes.
Seinfeld to a certain extent, but Curb to a much larger extent, is comedy based on awkward situations. That's really the crux of the show. He gets himself in situations that you can't imagine being in. And I think there is a small part of it. Yeah, he wants to paint himself as a sexual being. But I think there's also a part of it that it is so awkward to see that ugly skeletal Larry David in bed with his wife that's awkward. So there is an underlying comedy there, even though it's based on awkward.
I think you're giving him way too much
credit. Okay. We'll see.
I think he's missing
Mike,
the fact. There are plenty of awkward situations. Yes,
you brought it up. And talk about sexuality and life and happiness and what.
Yes.
Should I be jealous of this Kindle book that I found my wife reading? And I asked her about it. In a nice way. I said, hey, what's up with this book? Because she's always reading her Kindle.
Yeah.
She's not here. Okay, good. The book's title. Oh, no one should ever marry anybody that does this for a living because you get nothing private. Nothing private. Nothing.
But you've stopped the show. We are waiting. We are waiting with great anticipation right here.
I'm blushing and I'm also jealous.
Okay. What's the book called? Are you giving us the title?
Satisfaction Guaranteed. So I'm like, oh, this is not a Fabio novel. What the hell is this? So I guess you do a deep dive after that? Oh, no. I took a picture of the book because I needed details. Because I want to take a deep dive.
Why are you mining her Kindle?
I'm not mining it. It was set up in the bathroom.
All right.
You think he's spying on her?
Well, I mean, I don't know that I would even know how to access someone's Kindle.
No, it's she's reading it while she's like taking a shower or taking a bath or whatever she's doing.
I gotta know what's in the
book.
Me too.
Yeah, but it literally lays like this. So I walked in, I saw the cover. I'm like, hey, what's up with this?
Okay.
Satisfaction Guaranteed. Yeah, yeah. Is it a sex book?
Well, there's a good-looking man on the cover
saw. I'm attracted to this man.
Yeah, he's very nice.
So
he's not Larry David
or
Jeff Garland.
You know what? I'm going to still send this to you fellas and ladies. It is a doozy. And this guy...
So much for getting to the mailbag, Rob. I can't do it now.
That's right, Mike. Mail is not a system based on immediacy.
Okay,
right.
Mike, I'm going to let you describe this best because this is your professional here. It's coming to your inbox as we speak.
Via text.
Right, me take
it. Look at this book. Does it scream?
Oh my God, it's like porn.
The cat.
Millions of romance fans are hooked on Laura Blakely. Satisfaction guaranteed. She's the one who got away. He's the definition of off limits. It's a shot at a second chance is a shot at a second chance. Oof. Worth it. Oh, my God, Oscar. Oh, my God. Wow. It's a romance novel. She craves romance in her life. Oh, no.
She has romance.
And,
look
and
at
she's
me.
Got a, she's got a Kendall.
I see that cover of that book, Mike.
That is.
And I see a shirtless man in repose and a man who would never eat Five Guys in front of his wife.
With a cat.
Oh, my
And she
God.
Loves cats.
Sure.
And you know there have to be detailed sex scenes
I don't want
all
to
over this book.
I quietly said, you left your Kindle in the bathroom with the book showing. And she said,
wow.
So? Should I be worried about satisfaction guaranteed?
I mean, I think it's like you look at porn. She looks at that.
Mike,
so that's okay.
I wonder what
you know?
The cat symbolizes.
What's the cat?
There's a cat in the picture.
Man's holding
Where's the
a cat.
And on the book cover.
It's right under his nipple.
Oh, the cat's under the lettering. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Right. Maddie, have you seen these books? Should I be worried?
Do you know of a Lauren Blakely?
I do not, but I can't wait to ask Shannon.
Oh, God.
Reads.
No. Don't you dare.
She's sending you a signal.
No, there wasn't no signal.
This is a message.
She purposely left the Kindle there.
I'm sure.
Yeah, you know what?
I'm sure.
Why would it be on the cover? Wouldn't it default to where she was reading?
Maybe she was embarrassed
exactly.
of where she was reading.
Yeah, maybe she wants you to see
I
the cover.
I don't know how Kindle works. I just knew it was popped up, and that was in the cover.
She wants another cat.
Pony, this is why you'll always be single, but that was funny.
All right, well, I've got some quotes.
Details.
Oh, good.
Yeah, because I just decided I'd do that while we were talking.
Thank you.
Here, you know, let's see.
This is going to be painful
to
hear.
These are quotes of people. Let me see. Satisfaction guaranteed quotes. Ethan, you think I'm a hero? Yes, but lousy husband material. Like that really mattered to him. Beth, don't sweat it. So is Superman. Oh,
what?
That's not what I'm looking for.
That's
I'm looking for excerpt.
Mike, that's good writing.
Yeah.
So is Superman.
This is interesting.
This guy.
She's very popular. She's a very popular author.
Mm.
Oh, man. And I tell you, the color picture of the book is
oh, I
even
bet.
Dirtier.
I don't want to know.
Because it's wider.
I don't want to know.
Okay. Do you see how the Flash covers like his lower half?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
You almost get pube.
No.
In the
pubic bone muscle, because I like that.
Yes.
Sure.
You almost get pube.
Who doesn't?
I mean, I wish I tried. Yeah. I tried, I think, from my 20s to 26 to get that muscle.
No luck?
Never got it.
Yeah.
Then I gave up.
Is blurb, would blurb be a segment for
a blurb,
the
yes. That would be a blurb.
All right. Look, she started it. Rob, we need music for this.
Yes, all right. Please.
Yeah, we need music.
Blurb like my marriage, apparently.
All right.
My poor wife.
Wow. There it is.
I've just never seen such a graphic cover to one of these
There's
novels.
Some quotes from it. Let's give in just once.
Hold on,
I can
here comes
take
the music.
You places. I can make you feel extraordinary, like I've always wanted to. All right, let me see. Let me give you the whole blurb here.
Please, please.
Look.
No, not like that.
That's
not
fine.
Porn.
No, come on, it works. Come on.
Gross.
Look, she started it.
Yeah.
She issued me a challenge I couldn't back down from. Make her purr like no man has done.
Oh!
Enough!
Fine. She's my business partner's daughter. All right. I'm also working in the same damn practice with her, yes. It's terrible writing. She happens to be my ex-fling, but that was 7 years ago, and it was barely a week-long thing. Except Sloane is still the one I can't stop thinking of.
Of course it's Sloane.
Brilliant, sexy, captivating Sloane. Maybe a week of taking her to new heights will get her out of my head. So what if we spend a few nights on the town, too? So what if I romance her across Manhattan? It's all in the name of scientific pursuit of more magnificent OS or whatever the hell that is. Feel the rules. I don't know. It's like weird.
Oh, I don't feel so bad now. She hates Manhattan.
Yeah. Satisfaction guaranteed is a well-done, believable second-chance romance, and I loved it. The characters, the story, the laughs, and the love. All drew me into the book and wouldn't let me go. Malone and Sloane spent an amazing week together.
Yeah.
And the only reason they couldn't be together had nothing to do with them, but instead who she was. She's talking about an old fling.
Is Malone paying the mortgage? Did they mention that?
Is that review from a Shannon Z?
That is pretty fascinating
Shannon
Z14.
Yeah.
Well, look what you came to work with today.
I'm just telling
you. My God.
I didn't know. And she said, she goes, I don't want to hear it, like in a nice, fun way. And like, what is like, you shouldn't be jealous, but you should be jealous. Because
right.
I'm pretty good at reading tones of voices. And I was like, all right. And then so I jump in my Uber and I'm looking at this cover and I'm like, those guys' pecs can't be real. And then I'm looking at, I was like, that's got to be airbrushed. And then I realized.
I love the fact that she's reading a book that the content might be objectionable, but right away he's just zeroed in on the photo that's on the cover, which has very little with the reading of the book, right?
That's the Transformers mind.
Yeah, that is. It is. He's a fake pecs. Yeah.
He's the best educated of all of us, but when it comes right down to it, he's a rube too.
Yeah. I mean, that's it. Where's the
picture? Picture of Charlie Hunnam on front cover. That's it. That's all I care about right there.
He's swiping through the pages on the Kindle looking for the part about his pubic bone. Where is it? Where is it?
It's an interesting choice.
It is.
It's an interesting choice, well, and it's worthy of, I would be lying if I didn't say it was worthy of a discussion and a follow-up, but, you know, it's a normal novel. It's a popular bestseller.
Do you know her to read?
It's like 50 Shades of Grey.
Yeah, do you know her to read fiction?
Yes, she's read, I think that's what her go-to is.
Okay.
I've just never...
Is she a voracious reader? Is she
yes.
If she's got a Kindle, she probably
yes,
is.
Yeah, I would think so. I've never seen... I've seen romance novels in the past that she's been reading.
Right.
I would say even before we were married.
Does Carrie read romance novels? Does she read that? Is she a reader? Is she a big reader?
Carrie's not a reader.
Okay.
No. Right. She likes, she'll surf her phone and she'll read articles. She likes magazines. I don't think she doesn't have perhaps the attention span.
Playgirl?
Always, yeah. Just the issues that feature me.
How long
me.
Has that been out of print, Playgirl, right?
Well, magazines in general.
Are there any publications...
These guys.
Are there any publications like for women that show
women?
Men's, you know,
I don't think that's what women want.
I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want, whatever.
Well, Mike, it's just Entertainment Weekly that still shows the frontal.
So,
no, are there? There are none, right? There
I don't
are
think
no
so.
Magazines
I don't think
so. That show Maddie? Men's parts.
I can't think of any, but that okay. seems sexist that there aren't.
Yeah, I would think so.
I
yeah,
think
not
so.
Fair.
How about me too?
Yeah
that's right.
Yeah.
You call it.
Yeah.
No.
And to be
no.
honest with you, I remember back when that magazine came out, right around that time, that men in an office setting, this is back before sexual harassment,
right.
and you could bring stuff like that in, and they would show, they'd bring a Playgirl in, and the men behaved just like the women did with Playboy, because the men were all curious. And then after about three pages... All the guys would go, oh, come on. And as if they were saying, come on, no one can be that large.
And you ask your beautiful wife about...
Come here. Carla's taping across the hall. Yeah. You got to come right in.
There she just hi, Carla.
Hey, Carla.
So that's the book. That's the book that that Oscar found on Shannon's nightstand on her Kindle.
Should I be worried, Carla?
He wants to know if he should be worried.
Are you satisfying her sexually?
That's a personal question.
That's
probably not.
That's too personal.
I haven't done Pilates in some time.
Okay.
But, you know.
Well, hey, at least she's not
busy.
Going elsewhere. She's going to a book.
But
is she just going to a book or is she just reading? Maybe she likes to read.
Yeah, could be.
Yeah. I like to read that, too.
Oh, dear.
Send it to me.
Oh, dear.
Oh, and I'm fine with that. Knock your socks off. Let me know when you want me to walk the dog.
Yeah. Talk about boobies.
Or boobies. Yeah, well, that we haven't even gotten to that.
Oh. Okay, so I brought the water.
Thank you.
Yay!
Is that the clear water?
Can you tell the difference?
No.
That's our Berkey filtered water.
No, but what we're going to do, I thought it would be fun to have a taste test.
Oh,
that's a great idea.
Okay. Oh, right. Yes!
So, I will go get some water from the refrigerator.
No, not from the refrigerator, because that's got a filter. Get it from the tap.
Yes.
Okay.
Tap.
Let's I'll get it tap water.
We'll take a break, and we'll do that. We'll talk more about tap water and filtered water and Rob accusing me of being tired and cranky and Shannon reading a sex book when we come back right here on The Mike O'Mara Show.
It's The Mike O'Mara Show. You can listen to The Mike O'Mara Show at www.mikeomarashow.com.
Stay tuned for an outstanding entertainment program.
It's The Mike O'Mara Show.
Let's get down to business.
From the entertainment capital of the world.
This is Wade Byard, the public information officer for Loudoun County Public Schools.
The Mike O'Mara Show has decided to start now. Please make all necessary arrangements to listen. This is The Mike O'Mara Show with Mike O'Mara, Rob Spiewak, and Oscar Santana. And now, without further delay, here's Mike O'Mara.
Thanks, Wade. Did you put that? Is that a newbie? Is that? Did you put that together?
I think
together?
I did that a couple years ago, but we have we don't always run it. Don't
it's
always
Super
run
Bowl.
It.
Spiewak's little tribute to football going into Super Bowl weekend. We are live from the Podcast Village Studios in our nation's capital, Washington, D.C. This is the Mike O'Mara Show, a wonderful podcast and radio program. TMOS to our friends from Midland, Texas to Montauk, New York, Milton, Freewater, Oregon to Moshi, Tanzania, Washtenaw, Washington to Ballylickey, County Cork, Ireland. The Mike O'Mara Show is on now and brought to you by Ritual. Ladies. Carla, you know about this. Listen up. Everyone wants to keep their bodies healthy in the long run. Isn't that
yes.
right? And is that how we're going to do it?
Oh, it's going to be like Burns and Allen now?
That's why you need Ritual, the obsessively researched vitamin for women. Ritual's essentials have the nutrients most folks don't get enough of from food. Gonna be a little more.
Oh, that's true.
Take two easy to take capsules provide the 9 nutrients you need to support a strong foundation for your health. And there's a mint tab in every bottle to keep things fresh, because you don't get that fishy aftertaste common with most omega
3s. That's awesome, because I've had that before.
Thank you. Our wives, she's right here. Mm-hmm. One of them. Love Ritual.
The other one's
off reading, and the other one's reading a magazine.
Taking a nap.
Okay. Our wives love Ritual because they trust it. Check the label. All of their sources are out there for the whole world to see. Plus, they love that it's delivered. How convenient. You love stuff to
I
get
do.
It delivered.
Oh,
like
yeah.
Oh,
my
gosh. Present,
it's like a present.
Right?
Yeah. Yep.
It's only $1 a day to have all the essential nutrients your body needs delivered every month. No strings attached. Better health doesn't happen overnight, and right now, Ritual is offering our listeners 10% off during their first 3 months. Fill in the gaps in your diet with Essential for Women, a small step that helps support a healthy foundation for your body. Visit ritual.com/TMOS to start your ritual today. That's 10% off during your first 3 months at ritual.com. And in about a half an hour or so, we will be joined by Angie Goff, who
yes.
is live in the Miami area for the Super Bowl. Super Bowl XXYZZZZ.
Live! It's L-I-V.
Carla, we're going to get back to the book. We're going to get back to lots of fun. And Rob's kid had a talent performance last night. But before we do that, my wife has brought in 2 samples of water. Mm-hmm. It is tap water.
Yep.
And it is water from our new Berkey water filter.
Berkey.
Berkey.
Yeah.
Did I say that, Berkey?
Yeah, I like saying it.
All right. Would you like to throw a plug in for your business while
we
have you?
If you're ever in the Southwest Florida area and you would love an experience and a facial, please come to me. That would be Carla at DermGlow Skin, 239-247-4036. You won't be disappointed.
Excellent.
I promise.
Excellent
love
promo.
It. Love it.
All right. So mix them around. I'll keep my eyes
nice
covered
and tight.
Here.
Well, you don't. I don't need to.
Yeah.
Keep
them
that
all right.
Same
well, bring
spot.
It over here. Okay. Keep yeah. me that same spot. I'm going to take this one first.
Usually when there's a taste test, Mike.
Yes, you put the identity on the bottom.
No, or not even. She knows. She knows
which
one is
which.
Do you
know which one is the filtered water?
Of course.
Yeah. Right. You do this to prove somebody wrong or prove somebody right?
Exactly.
Why are we
to prove him wrong.
Okay, you're here to prove your husband wrong.
Right, we don't need that big old
Lean
Berkey.
In
we do not need that big old Berkey in our kitchen.
All right, here we go.
How big is it?
It's too big.
Wow. It's really, I'll show you a picture of
all
it.
Right.
All right, here we go.
First test. First sip of water.
Good sip. Smacks his lips.
That's the Berkey water.
He didn't even have to compare them?
Another glass.
Nice sip.
Smacks his lips. Another sip
back
for the other,
first.
Back to the first. Oh, you don't know which one
so
it
which
is.
One is which, Mike?
Hold on, I can't tell.
Right?
Did you pour both Berkeys?
No, I promise I didn't do that.
Which, all right. This one, I say, this one is the Berkey water.
Okay.
Okay.
You're wrong.
Oh, no!
That is the tap water.
He continues to taste
yes,
back and
yes.
forth for those of you on YouTube.
Right.
Yep. That's
this has
Berkey.
More of an aftertaste.
That's aftertaste?
Aftertaste. Get out of here. All right. Thank
hey,
you.
Hold on. Can I have one follow up question before she
yes,
goes?
Yes, go ahead.
What? Which of the two had the arsenic in it?
Oh, yeah, the first one.
That one, the one he thinks is Berkey. Okay, we're sending it back.
No, no, no. No, I just put the whole thing together.
Oh, you have to assemble
it? I did the work. Now we got to drink it.
Everybody get hydrated.
You, this is the Berkey?
That's Berkey.
All right.
Yeah.
All right.
All right.
Bye. All right. Bye.
Well, there's a potential advertiser gone.
She knows how to make a point, though.
You really had to have pissed her off with this cartoon size water filter.
And how hard was it to assemble?
It's true.
No going back.
So I got to ask, when your lead sales point was it filters out food coloring, is that like on their website? Is that their like go-to thing?
No, no. They actually are very scientific in their approach.
Okay, because I kind of envision it as like
it's
the guy
water filtration. Mike, it's water filtration. Yeah.
Just because you built the boat out of tape doesn't mean you have to use it.
That's right. Yeah. Yeah. Like it's that guy, expensive. The guy that makes the boat with tape and then goes out of crocodiles. I've seen him. He's great. It's waterproof tape.
I have to admit, it's all about the taste.
Maybe it's a placebo effect where you're like, oh, it's got to be better because I built a water cooler as big as the water boy.
I'll tell you, the Berkey water is pretty darn good. And you know what? Based on the tap water at our new location, I think water at this house that was a little better.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see what happens. I'm going to do another taste test. Yeah. I will do another taste test, and I will do one tonight.
With the
tap
water there.
I'll do 50
there.
This weekend. I'll do it all Super Bowl weekend. I don't care. Well, that's what I'm going
to
do.
There's no better time to drink water than the Super Bowl.
Mike, I thought you were boiling your water. That's why I thought we were on the same page.
No.
Shannon, I can drink the tap water.
Shannon will boil the water and then put it into the zero filter, and then that's the water we drink.
Uh-huh.
And at the bottom of that cauldron is all the residue of all the minerals.
Oh, because it settles.
It is surreal and gross to see.
Really?
Yeah, so maybe Carla will compromise and say, you don't want the Berkey? Let's go this route.
Boiling the water and putting it into a filter?
No, but the cauldron that comes in is a different appliance. So you could actually go through that same process, but you might get better water overall.
Well, I don't know. You know what? I read a lot about it. I bought it. It's in the house. It's goddamn staying.
How hard?
Thank you.
How long was the assembly? You said you had to put it together.
It was ridiculously stupid instructions.
Okay. All right.
It made it very, you know, the diagrams were non-existent and the instructions were so ridiculously put together.
Yeah.
And by the way, you couldn't go to the website and see this guy that put it together and it looked like the, you know, Ken from the mailroom who they brought up just to put this thing together.
Satisfaction guaranteed, Mike.
Yeah. I broke it as well. We have to open the mailbag. Yeah. We do. We're going to try to get it in 2 minutes. That's right. Because we didn't get to it all week, and I want to make sure people still send us things.
Yes.
Because that's important, all right? Yeah. Rob Spiewak has presents.
Yes, I know that. A present for you, actually.
And remember, if you send it to me this week, I will get it before the end of the year.
True. This comes from Matt Finarelli, and it reads, Dear Mike, I was listening the other day and heard you mention that you don't like tomatoes. And he goes on to say he's a chef, and he has written an Italian cookbook called Beyond the Red Sauce.
Ooh.
And these is an autographed copy of his cookbook, All Italian Recipes Without Tomatoes.
I would love to read that for when I cheat.
And also, here's the best part. It comes with a certificate. This would only be for the local people because he's a D.C. area guy, that he will come and do a cooking demo at your house.
Oh.
And I really want to give it to Oscar because I think he should have to cook in Oscar's kitchen.
The hot plates, Mike.
Wow, without the red sauce. What a great book, because most of my favorite Italian food does not involve red sauce.
You know who's going to get this?
Who's that?
Maddie the Mule.
Oh, that's right, Maddie.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah, give the book to Maddie.
Give the book to Maddie.
Okay.
And it says,
Maddie, congratulations. Oh, no. Re-gifting that to you.
I thought she was going to send it to you so you get it faster.
Yeah, we'll go out today.
I was talking about she might be interested.
The mail mule. Like you get
okay, the mail mule.
It is indeed autographed to Mike. Thanks for so many years of making me laugh.
Oh, yeah. All right. I'll take it. All right. It's autographed.
Bon appetito. Matt Finarelli.
Is Maddie bum now?
No, we'll get another one.
Yeah.
Maddie, do you want it? If you want it, you can have it.
It's quite all right, Mike.
Mike, Maddie,
I love it. I
have family recipes. It's okay.
Feel free to write down any recipes from the book before you mail it.
Half hour into the show, I'm exhausted. All right, here we go. So, anything else, Rob Spiewak?
That's it for presents. We can go into the mailbag now.
First letter says, Hi, everyone. My amazing husband, Jason, celebrated his birthday over the weekend. He has been on the keto diet like Mike. I am so proud of him for losing 20 pounds so far. He loves food and beer, so it's been tough for him, but he hasn't cheated at all. I was hoping Mike could wish him a happy birthday in his British guy with dental implants voice. They're doing another run.
Are they really?
I saw the commercial not an hour ago. I saw this commercial. It's fantastic. And make sure he lets Jason know that he is a, you know what, for sticking to his diet. Lots of love. Meg Griffin Hagenson and Pinniston. Hello, let me tell you about Jason. He's lost 20 pounds so far, and he's a rock star. He's a real rock star on his keto diet. I think I discovered the musical artist Prince. So I think I know what I'm talking about when I tell you that Jason's lost his 20 pounds on the keto diet. Jason, from me to you, a salute, because you are a rock star. Tim Moose Gabbert writes, sir, yes. How long can the fruitcake survive in the fridge if I forgot to freeze it? That's a good question. What do you think?
Actually, I had my last one in July of last year. Okay. So as long as you keep it cold, I would wrap it as tight as possible, and only because refrigerators have mysterious odors.
Make no guarantees.
That kind of seep in. So as long as it's
airtight. Can't you transfer it from the
refrigerator? Oh, you could freeze it now. You could freeze it right now, of course.
Yeah, freeze it. But just take it from the refrigerator, you dummy. And put it into the freezer, for God's sake.
You're talking to a guy named Moose. Maybe he needs a little help.
I like the name Moose.
Next letter says, guys, Moose? I love the segment with Paulie. Please consider making him a recurring part of the show. The man is podcast gold. Regards, Paulie.
No, I'm sorry.
Regards, Tom Murphy, St. Petersburg, Florida. That's very, very nice.
Regards, Paulie.
I'll take it under advisement. Hey, guys, I wanted to wish all of you and your families a belated Happy New Year. I remember Rob and Oscar discussing their hosting an annual art fundraiser in Northern Virginia. Would you please remind me of the date and location of the next event, for the name of the event, and I could look up more information online if you do that. Will Rob or Oscar be hosting again this year? Thank you, Kelly Crockett.
I have the information.
All right.
Do you have that Sunday free?
Yes.
So I guess we can do it.
What day?
It is the Sunday before President's Day, so that's Sunday, February 16th.
Yes.
So we'll do
that. Have they asked you to do it?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Yeah, but we haven't spoken because I knew this would come up on the show. It is at the Torpedo Factory in Alexandria. Tickets are available at Eventbrite. Just search Patrons Show.
Mike, you said you come up, you need some art from your house.
Yes.
I do. You got a beautiful piece of art.
Yeah.
What date is it?
An original.
February 16th.
Done. Dear Mike, Rob, Oscar, Pony, and Maddie.
See you there.
Penguin.
Tomorrow, my son Richard will be celebrating his 22nd birthday. He's a good boy who's just started at the communications school at George Mason University. He's hoping to do an internship at a well-known podcast. Welcome, welcome. We would love to have him. Let me see.
What's his name?
Oh, cool. All right. Hey, Zoo. Zoolander, if you're listening to me right now. Zoo, my sister made reservations at that place you recommended down in Key West.
By the way,
so I just wanted to pass that along.
Carrie has been there. She said it's mind-blowing. You're going to love it.
Everybody universally, this place is like...
I've been to Key West.
Talking
Where?
About how great
it is. It's Applebee's.
I will not give it a plug because it is associated with the guy that Rob and I like so bad. The guy we don't like so bad. And so, right, Rob? I will withhold
I think
until,
that's awesome. I think that's awesome.
I get back. Let's see. So anyway, you got the location and the date is February 16th.
Yes.
Go see him, Kelly Crockett.
Obviously, they forgave me for all the drinking last year.
22nd birthday. He's been a loyal listener for some time now. He was thoroughly indoctrinated by me. His new commute between GMU and Leesburg will give him more opportunity to listen. Thanks for all the great shows and for helping me get through my wonderful commute each day, too. Love you guys. Rich Haronic.
Haronic.
Thanks for the letter, Rich.
All right. That's Rich, tell your son Richard happy birthday and that he's a rock star. Thank you very much.
And you discovered Prince, so you know a thing or two.
I know a thing about real talent. That's why Richard's celebrating his 22nd birthday. My implant have worked out so very well for me. And anyone that likes this dental implant, please remember, as soon as they're as soon as they're installed in your mouth, you're going to become a rock star. Hey, Mike, regarding, you know, if you heard the commercial,
We know because you've taught us.
Regarding Adidas, your mother was actually pronouncing the name correctly. It comes from the name of the founder, Adolf Dassler, whose nickname was Adi. Originally, he was in business with his brother, but there was a split, and his brother created his own rival company, which is Puma. I first heard that pronunciation years ago from a roommate who had spent years in Europe. The more you know, Jim Moore from Olney. Adidas. As my mom pronounced it, God rest her soul.
Awesome.
Mike and Rob, I know you'll be able to help. If I wanted vintage or similar can-styled headphones to listen to my LPs on a vintage 1980 stereo, what would you suggest? I'm thinking of the kind of headphones that a kid with rich parents would have used in their bedroom to listen to Dark Side of the Moon or the like. Suggestions? Christopher Kellner.
Great question.
I do have a suggestion. First of all, I recommend that you buy Excedrin because they're the most uncomfortable things ever made, but they're Koss Pro 4AA. Koss, K-O-S-S Pro 4AAs. They were the ultimate headphone of the 1970s.
They still make them?
Oh, yeah, they do.
They look like the headphones you'd see on airport employees on a tarmac.
Yeah, they
that's what they kind of look like.
You use them for years, and the only thing that's changed is they no longer have oil in the ear pads, because remember it used to leak and you get that grease drip down your leg. So, but they're marvelously uncomfortable, but they're really loud. And what's great about them is really great. They hold the sound in.
May I give you maybe an upgraded version?
Yeah.
Marshall, the speaker company,
has just
come out with a, and I would say these are the finest in my opinion, depending on what fidelity you like for your music.
Mm-hmm. Right.
The beats by Dr. Dre, they're too bassy. There's too much bass with it.
That's why they don't work for broadcast.
But the Marshall headphones, those are the closest to real broadcast headphones or fidelity-wise that I have ever heard.
Where did you see them?
I saw them, of all places, I think it was Nordstrom.
No kidding.
Yeah, but you know, I tried the Beats, and you know what I like about the Beats? You know what I like about the Beats by Dr. Dre?
What's that?
He's a... and our final letter here says, oh, by the way, Rob, I have to ask you about, I have speakers, Edifier Bluetooth speakers.
Yeah.
That I have for my home, and they did not survive the move.
No.
It's coming out like...
Oh, okay. Frequency.
And I don't know what's wrong, and I don't know where to take them to get them fixed. Greetings and salutations. I'm writing in for a birthday request for myself. My birthday is tomorrow. I've been listening to Mike since I started driving myself to Oakton High School with WAVA blairing on my radio.
Say it
I'm
again.
A bonus show subscriber.
Say that again. I love hearing that. Say it
W-A-V-A.
Again. WAVA. Oh, yeah.
That's what I did. I was the promo voice of WAVA when I started. It's an all request weekend on Power 105. WAVA.
You know what? Yeah. He can make me 14 again. Like, that's so great.
This weekend, an REO Speedwagon tribute.
Keep on running.
Power 105 W. I don't think we were Power at that point. I am a bonus show subscriber. Hit. I've signed up with Noom this month, and I'm already down 5 pounds. I'm also a FabFitFun subscriber, and I love it. My 15-year-old daughter and I can't wait to see what's in the box. I love FabFitFun. I've sent a fruitcake to my aunt on the Cape for the last 2 years, and she loves them. I also have one in the freezer for myself, too. My one birthday wish is that Oscar will get back to me so we can finally set a date to get together. I have been trying to get Oscar to pin down a new date since he canceled our dinner out with our spouses at Jay Gilbert's last October. Thank you, TMO. Wow, he's going through the mailbag to get to you. Yeah. Thank you, TMOS, for all you do, and keep up the funny. And thank you for allowing us to be part of the family. Kim Marinas.
I know, Kim.
What say you, Oscar Sanchez?
Balls in your court.
Look, it's not me playing hard to get. I got hit by a car. So, literally. Because this date was supposed to...
Yeah, but it was months after you originally scheduled to meet with them. But you got hit by a car, right?
I got hit by a car, and the reschedule was supposed to happen after Las Vegas.
I see.
Right? And then the holidays came, and then I got the flu last week.
Oh, stop it. You just go out to dinner with her. You know what you're missing? You know what I know about Kim Marinas? Do you know?
Do you know the fact that I know?
She's a rock star. She is an absolute rock star. So go out for them,
please.
I'll
make it happen.
Anyway, we'll take a break. We have music? Oh, there we are. What is this?
This is. These are all football-themed records today. So this is the Beatles' Don't Pass Me By.
Anyway. Thanks. It's a great intro. You know, you want to really zoom into those rays. We'll... I'm ready for a... Hey, Maddie.
Yes.
How about a Beatle band on the show? What do you think?
I'd pass, personally.
You'd pass on the band or the Beatles?
Both. Oh, like a band.
Yeah, she's saying band.
I thought you said band.
No. How about a ban on Beatles
music?
Oh,
then I support that 10,000%.
There we go. That's why I went to
Never again.
Never again.
We'll take a break and we will come back with more fun on the Mike O'Mara Show, everybody.
In the National Football League, you challenge your opponent. You challenge yourself. But the elements challenge you. Santana Moss, number 89. The coldest game he ever played.
2013 season, the last game of the season we played at Giant Stadium.
He took precautions.
It was icy. It was slushy.
He protected his arms.
I had my normal sleeves on that was a little thicker, had a little thermal.
And his feet.
My normal socks. You know, with some feet warmers, I should be okay.
He remained steadfast.
I wanted every inch of every play.
Not every teammate was as dedicated.
Pierre Garçon has said, hey, deuces, I'm done. I'm on the sideline.
But Moss stayed true, even when he made this noise. Dedication, drive. Illness.
I thought I caught pneumonia that game.
The frozen turf proved no match for the ice in his veins.
I just wanted to be out there for my guys, win, lose, or draw, but I was freezing.
Arctic cold was defeated by Santana Moss, playing every game as though it was your last. The Santana Moss Show podcast. Find it on iTunes, YouTube, and wherever you score your content.
Oh, I love that. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, brought to you by KiwiCo. We all love a good subscription box.
Yes.
Right. They're all the rage. Say hello to KiwiCo. KiwiCo is a subscription. It's a KiwiCo subscription, the perfect activity kit for kids, young explorers, engineers, and artists. The young kids in your life, they're going to do things with their world. KiwiCo creates super cool hands-on projects for kids to make learning about STEAM fun. Now, I've heard of STEM, but until KiwiCo, I didn't know about STEAM. STEAM is science, technology, engineering, art, and math.
I love STEAM. The fact that they throw art in there. I think that's important.
Absolutely. Michael loves his. He gets a new box every month. Each box has all the supplies needed for that month's project with easy instructions and an educational magazine so the learning continues. KiwiCo is a convenient, affordable way to encourage your children to be anything they want to be. No commitment, and you can cancel anytime. Monthly options start at $16.95 per month, shipping included. Our listeners can go to kiwico.com/TMOS to get their first month free. That's KiwiCo.com/TMOS. Every day counts when it comes to making a difference. So don't miss out on this amazing opportunity. Again, go to kiwico.com/TMOS and get your first month free. That's kiwico.com/TMOS. And I have to mention a couple of things quickly here.
All right.
If I can. Carla made a reference to it. I just wanted to make a reference very quickly. That we went out to dinner with her and her girlfriends. Did I tell you that story?
No,
on the show?
Not at all.
No, you teased it multiple times this week, but we have not.
First of all, it's a Tuesday night. You know, it's middle of the work week. I got to be in here. Got to be ready to go. I didn't feel like making a super late night, but originally we were going traffic down here. Welcome to Fairfax. It is now bumper to bumper. I sat in bumper to bumper.
Is it because of the snowbirds?
I have no idea. It could be. I both times have been around the 5 o'clock
hour. Spring training is about to start. People are getting in town.
Mm-hmm. And well, they may be. It might be. They do have a rush hour down here, so it might have been that as well. But it's been. We were trying to get down to Cape Coral to go to this place we went last week, where it just the traffic was undoable. So we all decided that we are going to Carla and her two girlfriends. We're going to go down to the River District, all the way downtown. Takes a little less time, and it's going to be
down
fine.
By the river.
Were you going to go and there and get water for your new thing?
Get right out of the river. The Caloosahatchee, Rob.
Oh, that's a great river.
The Caloosahatchee River. Yeah, man, Billy Joe McAllister jumped off the Caloosahatchee. Anyway, so it's a nice evening. I'm drinking my new beverage,
Olive Garden. It was lovely.
It was lovely. I'm drinking my new beverage of the Diet Tonic and Gin.
Okay.
Which seems to have just, my liver seems to have compensated for it rather quickly. The first weekend I had them, I'm like, I had two. And I looked at Carl and I said, this is a pretty good drink that I'm drinking right now.
Do you find now, when you change horses alcohol-wise, there's like a honeymoon period where it's very effective right from the start, and then it wears off.
It wears off, and so I'm drinking this kind of pseudo bitter limey crap, and kind of going, you know, not as special, not as special as it was. Might be the gin too. I don't know. There are lots of theories. A lot of people have opinions. Gin drinkers have a lot of opinions.
Oni likes
on
gin.
What is the best gin?
You know, I think Sapphire, not a great...
Just because we mention your name doesn't mean you need to...
No, I want to hear it. I want to hear it. Sapphire what?
I don't think Sapphire is a great gin for gin and tonic because it just has so many other spices in it. I think if you go with something...
Tanqueray.
Yeah, Tanqueray is perfect.
Yeah.
All right, Tanqueray it is.
Or what about the old Bombay?
Hey, the old Bombay. Yeah, you're going to put the Bombay grease. There you go. Pour it in the glass. Strap on a gun and become a lawman. Hey. We have so many maggots on the... I was going to say, Pony, as far as you're a big gin drinker,
yes.
The buzz factor, which is really, because I'm going down from like a few beers to a couple of drinks, what would have the biggest kick in your opinion?
Biggest kick is going to be Hendrix.
And that's 45 proof, right?
Yeah.
I mean, 45%, 90 proof.
Sapphire is right there as well. I think
Sapphire has two strengths. I think they have an 80 proof and a 90 proof.
I'd like to get the Sapphire Mind Eraser. It's as far as gin goes, it's a rock star. It's very, very is. So if you were to say you're the last gin on the planet, what would you get? Would you get the Tanqueray?
No, I would get Hendrix. Hendrix gin with a little bit of cucumber. It is the
on a budget,
best
for
gin
sakes.
Ever.
Is that the blue bottle?
No, it's the big black glass bottle.
Okay, all right, yeah, I've seen it. It's costly.
I've never had it.
Yeah, it's
expensive. That's how special it is.
That's how I like my gin.
Yeah, you
big
do.
And black.
That's right. That's right.
I don't know what that means.
Just like your men.
Yeah.
I just thought.
And your coffee.
Satisfaction guaranteed.
For the dummies in the audience, you just had to give a little tip. Because somebody just heard me say that.
I watched Airplane. And
then, yeah. It is a joke from Airplane. Yeah.
Cut me some slack, Jack.
You're drinking gin and sitting with some broads.
And that goes well. We go to this place. And we have dinner, and because I can only eat protein, I order a steak, and it's one of those places that has the super grill where it's char, 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 where they serve the vegetables with the char on them and the steak with the char. And I don't like char. I don't like that. I don't like anything that's overly charred on the outside, and that's all this place was.
Right.
And so I'm drinking my drink, and maybe the honeymoon period, as Rob said, was over. So I'm drinking my drink, and I'm going, and then I'm having my meat, and I'm going, and nothing tasted good. But, you know, the conversation was fine. And at the end of the evening, I'm kind of looking around the room and the three hens are, you know, going, and that's what it sounds like to me. I'm not hearing anything other than, and then I hear, boobs, and boobs. And they're talking about boob jobs.
Oh.
And I hear them going back and forth, and they're saying, boob job. Well, I think that if you're going to do it, I didn't smash my hand down on the table, but I stopped and I said, excuse me, I have a penis. This is not a conversation. Have this conversation in your spa. Have this conversation at your hair salon. Don't have the conversation with me. I am a being that has some magnetism, and your conversation is indicating to me that I'm just a eunuch sitting over there like the help that you can have this conversation about.
I think you've got this all wrong. I think you've got this completely wrong. They're having this conversation in front of you because they're with your wife and they feel like she is in this world of dermatology now, that it's almost like a work conversation. So it's not because they don't care about you. It's because they liken you as a brand extension of your wife and that you should be comfortable with this conversation.
Or maybe, Mike, even more, it might be the delicate dance of seduction.
No, absolutely not that one. Both of you are wrong. One of you is more wrong. I didn't feel as though I was any extension other. I was the old man, the non-sexual being sitting there eating, you know, picking at his asparagus. That's what I was.
He can't hear us. Don't worry. Go ahead, girls.
Right. Exactly. All right. He's not, all right. So now, is TV Lady standing by, like you said before, or is it the usual where they tell you a time and it's not the time?
What's the time?
We are waiting for the text.
I have a follow-up.
I think it'll be in the next
minute or so. Angie is doing 3 minutes TV hit at 9:30. She'll text when she's ready, likely 9:34. Said the man looking at his watch at 9:37.
If it happens, we'll find out. If it doesn't, no worries. I have a follow-up for the question that and the conversation you just brought up.
Yes.
Your wife briefly said, we're going to get you a pellet. And the only thing I know about pellets is pellets that you feed little animals. I don't know what a pellet is. I don't know what she was talking about.
Yeah, she was putting it in my butt or
something.
An injection or something like that?
We didn't know. That's as far as it went.
I don't know either. And by the way, I ain't letting that happen. I ain't letting somebody put somebody at a place where they, you know, do facials to shoot me in the ass with something. That's not going to happen. That's what you hear about people.
That's not your face.
Yeah, you know what? You know something? Seriously, I'll go down there and some guys will be, yeah, I feel great now. And he'll be walking out and they're going to shoot me in the ass and 3 weeks later I die of the coronavirus.
What is a pellet? No one knows.
You know why I might never find that out? Because I'm not going to ask and I'm not going to push the issue. You want to give me a facial and exfoliate my ass? Go right ahead. But I'm not going to have a needle put into my body when there's not Dr. Kildare standing over me, okay? I've had enough needles and enough surgeries. It will not happen. It does not compute. Well, I don't know. I don't know what's going on.
Get the pellet.
Please don't do that.
All right, we'll take a break.
We will take a break, and when we come back, ladies and gentlemen, we will speak with the one and only, hopefully, Angie Goff, as I knew it would be, right here on the Mike O'Mara Show. Guaranteed.
Ha! Kenny the Cactus again. Oh! I'm Fredo the Ficus. I'm Kenny's oldest Paisan. Not too long ago, Fredo and I decided to do a podcast together, but we couldn't agree on a topic. I wanted to do a podcast on desert plants. And I wanted to do a podcast on movies. Oh, forget about it. I said, Fredo, I'm a cactus, stupid. I don't have eyes, so I can't watch movies. Well, until we can agree on a topic, at least we can listen to the Mike O'Mara Show using our favorite podcast app. I like to use Apple Podcasts. And I like Spotify. Oh, forget about it. Italian stereotypes. All you have to do is open your favorite app and search for the Mike O'Mara Show. And now, back to the man with the deepest roots, Mike O'Mara.
Is that Blind Glenn?
No, that's John Crandall.
And is John visually challenged?
I don't think so. He's submitted promos as the cactus before.
That is fantastic.
I do like it.
Thank you very much. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show. Brought to you by No Emmy. Shopping for fine jewelry can be overwhelming, especially considering the fact that most fine jewelry retailers mark up prices by 500 to 1,000%. Noemi believes that luxury jewelry doesn't have to be overpriced, but they cut out the middleman to deliver exceptional products without the exorbitant markup. Finally, a customer service company that just happens to sell jewelry. I just got Carla the 3-stone single diamond earring, and she loves it. It's gorgeous.
Gorgeous.
It's a great solution for Valentine's Day. Noemi also offers a lifetime warranty and free shipping and returns on every product, including engravings and custom designs. If you're looking for the finest quality jewelry from a luxury brand you can trust, look no further than Noemi. Go to HelloNoemi.com/TMOS to see their collections and get $50 off your first purchase with promo code TMOS. That is an even better deal after spending a fraction of what you'd pay for other luxury brands. I see you. Just go to Hello, HelloNoemi.com/TMOS.
Woo!
And don't forget to use promo code TMOS for $50 off your first purchase, everybody. And now, let's go to Miami, Florida, and check in with Angie Goff, who's been very nice in her busy TV schedule to check in with us today down in my state, Miami, Florida. Hello, Angie.
I forgot you were down here.
Yes. Yes. I know. I'm right across the alley. I'm over here on the other side of the state. And, you know, the other day they had an earthquake in the Caribbean, and they were talking about Miami building shaking. You weren't in town early enough for that, were you?
No, I was. I've been here since Monday, and I can't believe you haven't called.
I'm sorry. I apologize. My sister and brother-in-law came in, Angie. It was just a very, very busy week.
You don't even like your family. Excuse to get away.
I know. Over there to the Super Bowl. So, so exciting. Angie, before we ask you about the Super Bowl, how is your wonderful Oh My Golf podcast going? Because I love your promos.
Oh, well, thank you. Yes, I try to tailor them to you, Mike. I do. I put a lot into those. But I'm loving it. It's been fantastic. We actually have one that's coming out today, if I can get my act together. But it's been wonderful. I mean, the guests, you know, they've run the gamut. We've had the guy that took down Pablo Escobar, and then, you know, we've got athletes, and it's really fun. And as you know, I mean, it's just such a different experience than what you're used to in the mainstream. So, honestly, I don't think that I could be happy in my main job if I wasn't doing this. So.
Oh, that's wow, great. That's I know sweet. A lot of people that are on TV feel the same way once they start doing this. So you're down there. It's a busy week. It's the Niners. It's the Kansas City Chiefs. And how many? You've been to these before, right? You've covered these before, haven't you?
No. Well, not the Super Bowl. I mean, I did the World Series. But this is a first for me, actually, coming down. Wow. And really, you know me. I don't know anything about football.
Right.
And I don't really know anything about Miami, so it's like it's the perfect assignment. So they sent me down here, and they were like, "That's great, you know, just go down there and be like the rest of the people." Because the majority of people are like it too. I mean, almost everybody I interviewed that's down here, they're here to go to Gronk's Beach Fest on Saturday. They're here to party, to be a part of the atmosphere, and then you know me, I like to just kind of have fun with anything, and which we did, you know, from day one. Like, you know, Monday we had opening night, which was an incredible experience, and that's where you have the chance to actually, you know, get in there and ask the coaches anything or the players.
Yeah.
I asked Shanahan if he missed Washington, and at first he goes, "That's a trick question," and then he was like, no, I don't, and he was very, you know, yeah.
It's been so long. It's been so long since we've done one. But it's funny because it's very corporate when you go to a Super Bowl. There are lots of exclusives, exclusive parties. Media usually, especially TV media, gets you to the front of the line. Have you enjoyed any particular events, exclusive, exciting events that the common men can't get into?
Well, I mean, I think even like opening night, like just dressing up as like Andy Reid. I don't know if you saw that video, but
it is classic.
So great.
Is classic.
Yeah. So, and he was cracking up, and you know, I was eating cheeseburgers as I asked him his question and asked him about buns and if he likes them softer, if he likes them firm. And he said, it depends on what kind of meat. And then he told me like my mustache and that he thought it was better on me. And then, so that was fun. And then getting Patrick Mahomes to sign my shoes, and, you know, calling Jimmy G, you know, ask him how it feels to be the hottest quarterback and calling him baby, you know, because he always, you know, when
so
he does
great.
Talk, the word baby is always there.
Yes.
You talk about like it being like a serious thing. I mean, I was under the impression opening night is like a free-for-all, and it was like some of the looks I got, like I guess these were like real serious, like sports journalists, but I'm like, hey, baby, and it's like their eyes rolled in the back of their head. They're like,
way
oh
to
my
go.
God.
Way to go, awesome.
Angie. Yeah. Yeah.
I love that.
Who let this girl in? Why is she dressed like Dorothy? You know, and it's just like, I kind of was like, guys, get a life. We're at the goddamn Super Bowl.
Have fun.
God.
Yeah,
enjoy yourself.
Have fun.
That is so glad to hear that. That is
great. And then we had J-Lo and Shakira's presser yesterday, so I got there real early because I wanted front row. And, of course, I had to bust out my green J-Lo dress.
Oh, you wore it?
She wore it.
Oh, that's great.
I wore it, yeah. And I saved a tweet. I tweeted A-Rod, told him I was saving him a seat, and he never showed up.
Oh.
But you know, they kind of something like that, they preset the question. So, of course, like, entertainment tonight and Access Hollywood, they all get to ask the question, which, by the way, they all ask the same goddamn question. I was like, are you kidding me? I was dying. I was, like, literally exploding inside. But it was, but the best part, thank goodness for James Corden's father. because I guess James Corden couldn't be there, so he sent his parents, and his father shows up with a saxophone, and he starts playing Jenny from the Block. I was like, these are my people. And then J-Lo told him he was out of key, and then he asked Shakira, hey, you know, I'm here with my wife here, and he has, like, this Irish accent, and I'm not going to attempt it, because every time I attempt an accent, it's Asian. It doesn't sound right. So he's like, can you... you know, show us, you, I know your hips don't lie. Can you show us how to, you know, maybe a move? And she's like, oh, I charge for that. No fun. Hello.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
I know, that's exactly J-Lo. What the gallery sound like. They were like, oh. So they leave. But I'm like, you know what? I don't charge a dime, James Corden's dad. So he started playing, and I had a big jam out with him, and he loved it. And he told me I was brilliant. So, I mean, that's
brilliant,
like...
Yes.
And then, you know, I had Ric Flair last night. I was dressed as Pitbull walking around. And, you know, Ric Flair walks out. And I'm like, oh, my God. I was like, can you teach me how to woo? And he's like, I already taught Pitbull how to woo. And I was like, that's okay. You know, and he taught me. And he told me that he thinks the Chiefs going to win. And he met his new wife. I think it's like maybe, I don't know. I think him and Mike probably are about the same when it comes to that. Like,
a wife?
Yeah. They're a fourth wife or something like that.
Angie, you know? How many bags did you have to check? It sounds like you're traveling with a costume store.
Really?
Yeah, I got, one was way overweight. So I did. I had a second. When you get
this
over 75
brilliant.
Pounds, you know, they charge you like 200. So I got two different bags. And then, of course, I'm going to leave with more than, you know, I came with, so I might have to get another. But yeah, there were a lot of, you know, fun costume changes. And, you know, it's just, I had a lemur jump on my back yesterday. It's just, like, only in Miami.
Angie,
right?
God, you have had the most amazing week. It sounds spectacular. Are you going to actually be going to the game, or are you winging it back to D.C. before the game starts?
No way. I'm going to catch a flight home today.
That's fantastic. Perfect. Oh, my God. Well, would you like to give us your pick for the Super Bowl? Do you have a particular team that you're expecting to win?
Yeah, you know, I was just because I feel like me and Andy Reid really had a connection in that moment. I think that I might be pulling for him.
Okay,
you know,
the Chiefs.
He just seems
That's
like a
Chiefs.
Really good guy. Yeah,
that's
the Chiefs.
Cool. I like the whole Andy Reid connection. That's awesome.
And while we're talking predictions, Nikki could not join us today. Cricket Wireless took his phone away, but he did mail me his predictions. So,
right, and
Nikki Diamond, Niners going
to
win 31-27.
Okay.
He predicts Jimmy Garoppolo as MVP, and he also predicts a dress malfunction for Shakira. So stay tuned, and we'll see what happens.
And Angie,
and I predict
Angie,
we're going to see A-Rod everywhere.
Now,
I bet.
Angie, for the DC faithful, plug your new home, your new television home. Give them plug. Come on.
Oh yeah, join us always on Fox 5 DC, 4 p.m. and 7 p.m. for Like It or Not, and then always online at the Oh My Gosh Show at a Podcast Village.
You
oh, that's so
thank
sweet.
You so
thank
much
you.
For taking some time to talk you. To us. We appreciate it. Enjoy your flight back and good work down there. Thank you so much.
Okay. Happy Friday. Okay.
That's Angie Goff. That's Angie Goff, everybody. And,
so smart.
That's so cool.
Making national news, Mike. I've seen her on all these other networks.
Yeah. Oh, we maybe could talk about it on the bonus show. On the bonus show this week, we'll do a behind the scenes kind of analysis of that whole vibe they give you with the NFL and the Super Bowl.
And I'm hearing her talk about it.
There's so many traditionalists there. It's hysterical.
Hearing her talk about it makes me think it might be even worse now.
Oh, absolutely.
You know what I mean?
I don't doubt it for a second. All right, we'll take a break, and I don't even know where we are on the show, but we'll do something when we come back.
Okay, I think
right
that's a good idea.
On the Mike O'Mara Show.
Hey, how's it going, my TMOS friends? This is your boy, Tomo. You probably haven't heard from me in a while because I've been deplatformed. I've been censored. Yeah, that's what happens when you love this country. They just cancel culture. Yum. Well, the good news is TMOS is still spreading the message that the mainstream media wants to hear. Today's show is brought to you by foodprepper.darknet. They may have deplatformed us, but you still need to eat. All right. Well, if you need me, I'll be down in Florida in my bunker. Yum.
Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, brought to you by Cornerstone. If your goal for 2020 is to buy a home, listen up. 2020's housing affordability is at a record high. As of right now, it is actually cheaper to buy a home than it is to rent. Here are the facts. With historically low interest rates and low down payment options, experts say it's currently 30% cheaper to buy a home than throw your money away in rental payments. Furthermore, so I have to say,
what are you waiting for?
Furthermore, with the
limited inventory,
experts are predicting the spring housing market will start within a month. Hurry up! Quit wasting your time and your money. You need to work with the experts at Cornerstone First Financial. Whether you want to purchase or refinance, call my friend Mark Livingstone, who has all the programs. Plus, with his low rate guarantee, you can't go wrong. They carry my personal endorsement. You know that's true. I'm Mike O'Mara, and I guarantee it. Because Mark Livingstone... Because Mark Livingstone...
Is
a virtual. Call 202-625-1221. That's 202-625-1221. Or check the web at cornerstonefirst.com. Cornerstone First Financial. Personal attention from application to closing. Are we so late that this is... We have one more break?
Yeah, we do. Now, here we could...
Wow.
We
what could, happened to our time?
We the Angie booking was a little off, and it threw us a little bit. We
Where
can do a fast break
show?
Here, and then we can come
we
back and do the audio vault.
Can we talk about the talent show, or do we... is that something that's...
No, we can absolutely talk about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I'd love to... You, because
all right, your son had his talent show. Mr. Tuscarora.
Yes.
It was a what was it? Some sort
like
of beefcake show? Or
it was what it is. It's put on by the student government, I believe, at his high school. And it is a fundraiser. They the admission was like $5 or 5 canned goods for the needy. And
yeah,
there
they
was
all are.
They all submitted applications. 7 kids competed. And at the end, 3 were recognized. There was, of course, Mr. Tuscarora, the first runner-up. Should anything happen to Mr. Tuscarora,
right.
The first runner-up.
Fulfill all the duty.
Exactly. And then there was an honorable mention. So.
That's awesome.
He did not finish in the money.
Oh, no.
Which is a little disappointing.
That
because
is a little disappointing.
3 of 7 is really not asking a lot. However, I know a lot of these kids and have known a lot of these young men since they were wee and small. And there's
Is it like a beauty pageant?
It is a male beauty pageant. It starts out with they're escorted out in their quote unquote formal wear. Then there is a talent portion. There is a Q&A with the judges, but also in between.
What was Robert's talent?
Robert's talent was, and I have to give him credit because he's never been the showy one of my two kids. Julia's always been the one that's done stuff on stage. He came out and did a magic act. And this was his entrance music. He learned a trick and he had a plant in the audience and he pulled it off. And he had patter and he was like, you know, doing sort of a... dramatic gestures in tune to the music.
Like Karnak or like David Copperfield?
More like Copperfield. Okay. Like sort of, but he's like, and now we're going to explore the world of magic. And it was sort of a jaw dropper for me because I've never seen him do anything show busy before. He's never been in a play. Even when he took a theater arts class, he only built sets. So this was... Very,
what
very
was the
fun.
Trick?
He had his plant in the audience, Ben, pick a card from a sealed deck of cards, and then he had Ben sign his name and his birthday, and then he shuffled the cards, and he had one of the judges look under her desk, and the card was there with his writing on it.
Mm. Mm.
Now, I mean...
Did he get a woo?
It doesn't take a brilliant man to figure out what went down. But you know what? He got up there and he did a magic act and he wore a cape and he was dramatic and he was funny and he was good. I was so proud
of him.
Who
was the best? Who was the best? What was the best act?
The best act was this kid that came out and he was called Freshman 3. They all went by different nicknames. Robert's nickname was Mr. Sauce because he's Saucy Spiewak, whatever. But Freshman 3... This is his third time in
Mr. Tuscarora.
You know,
if we were talking about anybody else, Rob would have a joke.
Right I know.
Now.
So many jokes.
Rob
so
would be the first one.
So many jokes.
Absolutely.
Named did you ask him maybe he wanted to go with a different name? Maybe
no, he's been Saucy Spiewak for a long time.
Well, Saucy
Spiewak. Well, it's based on my nickname, Mike, around the house, Hollandaise.
Yes, so, Hollandaise. Thank you. It's not the holidays at the Spiewak house. It's the Hollandaise.
That's right. There's no place like home for the Hollandaise.
Right, exactly.
So this kid, freshman three, he comes out. He's called this because this is his third time being in the competition.
Yes.
And also, coincidentally, his third loss. He comes out and he says, I am going to present, and he had dramatic music too, the Gauntlet of Pain. I'm like, okay, this is interesting. The first thing he does is he eats a habanero pepper, and he immediately starts sweating and retching. Fantastic. And then he pours.
That's good. I'm watching. That's interesting.
Wait, it gets better. He gets an onion, and he puts his face down by the onion and starts chopping the onion, so he's crying. Then he has his assistants come out and pull huge adhesive bandages off of his legs, which were hairy, and they just rip them off. And then the game changer,
yes.
The thing that made me say,
how
this kid is
going to,
he takes out a Ziploc bag of Legos and sprinkles them on the stage in a pile. He's barefoot.
That's awesome.
He's barefoot, and he takes a 3-foot jump, lands barefoot into the Legos.
Oh my God.
Swear, it must have been the reaction that you would get in the old days when someone sawed a lady in half, because there was 250 people in the audience, spectacular. And he landed on the Legos, and they went, But I will.
That's more like Chris Angel.
Yeah, it
right?
was.
Yeah,
exactly.
Was
exactly.
The Gauntlet of Pain.
The Gauntlet
hysterical.
Of Pain was my favorite act. Then there was some guy that did like TikTok dancing. Some guy. There was a lot of dancing. They all fancy themselves dancers, which is fine.
Boom.
One kid came out and did, this was funny, a fake juggling act. He juggled with no balls, but just all pantomime, and then brought a teacher from the audience and did like a fake handoff, and the teacher started to pretend to juggle. And I mean,
hysterical.
He's doing the things like throwing it up and catching it behind his back, but there's no balls.
That's hysterical.
It was, and they did.
So it was really lighthearted,
Very lighthearted, and it raised a lot of canned food for the needy. And just for me as a dad, I was pleased because I saw a side of Robert that I've never seen before.
Aww.
And he mentioned in his bio, and Oscar has the program, he says, in 2019, Robert Spiewak bought a Gucci belt and has been wearing it ever since.
That's funny. Was Mrs. Spiewak at
yes,
the show?
And as a matter of fact, we were both there. We both cheered.
Did you sit next to each other?
We did, as a matter of fact. We came in separate cars, but we sat together. And I think the sweetest thing is about 8:30, we got a text from Julia. She says, did Robert win?
Oh,
that's awesome. That's
very
awesome.
Sweet.
But anyway, as I told Robert before the show, I said, no matter what happens, I'm proud of you. And I was. I thought he did
a
great job.
Was the winner a dreamboat? Was the winner a dreamy kid?
All I care about, well, they're all dreamy, Mike, in their own ways. But I know, as I was going to say before, I knew most of the kids that were up there. And one of them is a total bastard, and I'm glad he lost.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, I can relate. We'll take a break.
I'll point him out
back
to you later, Oscar.
With a mini audio vault right here on the Mike O'Mara Show, everybody.
And now, advice from Andrea.
Hello, this is Andrea, the Italian TMOS intern. Here is my advice for dating. Remember, a man should always ask a woman for the date. Young adults must only date one person at a time. Pick your date up at her house and come to the door. A man gives his date's order to the waiter. And remember to walk your date all the way to her door at the end of the evening. Then, and only then, can you make sweet, sweet love. Ciao, Bella.
Ciao, Bella. Okay. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, brought to you by Zappos. 2020, I'm loving this year already. I really am.
I know you are.
Really?
I loved writing that down for you to read.
It's only going to get better. It's the bicentennial of Maine statehood. I am a fan. Only 1 week until the D.C. Chocolate, Wine, and Whiskey Festival. No diabetic alcoholics need to tend. I'll say it right next time. And the 2020 United States presidential election is scheduled for Tuesday, November 3rd. It will be the 59th quadrennial presidential election. Voting is a privilege, right, Oscar?
Yes, absolutely.
And the Summer Olympics hit Tokyo for the first time since 1964. Get ready for the heart-pounding excitement of speed skating. Such fast. 2020 also marks the 20th year
that Zappos continues
to offer over 1,000 trusted brand names to help millions of customers create a long-lasting wardrobe they love. No matter what it is, if you wear it, get it at Zappos. We just ask that you support us both by clicking the Zappos banner through our website. Click the banner. As always, Zappos provides free shipping. It's fast. It's free. Free, easy returns, 24/7 friendly customer service, and a 365-day return policy. Thank you, Zappos. You make us look good all year long. Remember, only 174 days until the Olympics begin. So sharpen your skates. Am I right, ladies?
Yeah, ladies.
Yeah, am I right? Right. Let me get this here over there. There it is. Open up the audio ball. Take it away, Rob. Just a few seconds left.
Yeah, we got it. We just a few quick things. You may be wondering, everybody have plans for the Super Bowl. I'm going to stay home but do some cooking for myself. You're going to a
going
party,
going to my
right?
buddy's house, yep.
Mm-hmm. Oscar? Going to, you know what? My dad called and said, would you mind coming and watching the big game with me here in Olney?
Well, that's nice.
Isn't that nice?
I like that. That's a good one. I like that.
That'd be nice.
Very nice.
But I think everyone's going to be excited about all the food you're going to eat.
Definitely, Super Bowl is like the queso, the Frito-Lay scoops with the Rotel situation. I guess it's like, what's the Black IP stuff too? All of that. Just stuff you can just sit there and have a lot of sodium. And then
you
just,
succeeded.
It's like Thanksgiving.
You've
all
won
over
me
again.
Over.
I said,
you've won me over. I hate him now, too.
Let's talk about the Rotel situation.
Now, what he's mostly talking about is savory foods, but he will enjoy some sweet things when he eats his licorice hat.
There you go.
Buffalo right. Chicken
Bryan.
Dip.
All right.
Rob
Luke Bryan
does not like Luke Bryan.
I don't know what he's eating with black eyed peas at the Super Bowl. Cut it out. All right, name this sound.
I got it.
Oscar.
Mating.
Of?
Of two?
Pigs.
Thank you.
Wrong. Name that sound.
I got it.
Oscar.
Mating of two bullfrogs.
Not mating at all. Name that sound.
Is it an animal?
Yes. Answer, please. Time.
It's a rabbit.
It shocked me to find out that is a koala. Those
really?
Adorable marsupials, they're called koala bears. They're not bears, they're marsupials. But that's the sound a koala makes.
Doing what?
Just being a koala.
You know, we had a general manager back in the day, Michael Hughes. And that's the same sound that used to come out of the bathroom when he'd be in there. Let me listen. One more time. Michael, are you in there?
He also had a pouch.
I've never heard that sound ever.
No, it's a close-up like at a petting zoo of a koala. And I said, that's not a... I thought they would like coo.
Because all we watch on the... tragically right now on the news is them just getting water and being
exactly.
sweet.
I
right?
know. Yeah. Poor things down in Australia with all those fires.
Yeah. And this is what you choose?
Yeah.
Thanks, Rob.
By the
it's
way, that koala came in fourth at Mr. Tuscarora. So that's good. Okay, I want to close with this. I don't normally go with people that just go on Twitter and do stuff because they're annoyed with things. Mm-hmm. This is a guy, I thought this was really funny, making fun of the local news teases that go to spots.
Okay.
And this is him making fun of his local news. I thought this was pretty funny.
Up next at 11, over the river and through the woods to grandma's house we blow. 3 pounds of cocaine were found. Up next at 11, the butcher, the baker, the candlestick faker. How you can tell if the wax in your candles is not. Up next at 11, one if by land, two if by tree. How a British man got stuck in an. Up next at 11, no shoes, no shirt, full service. We talked to the owner of a bar who has everything wrong. Up next at 11, sing us a song, you're the piano manatee. How one porpoise is using music. Up next at 11, knick-knack, paddywhack, give a dog a drone. How one plan to arm canines might be coming sooner than you think.
That's your magic audio vault. That's have a
awesome.
Great weekend and enjoy the big game, everybody.
Oh, what happened? All right, come on, play my thing. Where's my thing? Come on, close it. Michael, come on.
Give
what
a
is
dog
wrong
a drone.
With my computer today? I don't want to end this show like...
We'll do it in
hello.
Post.
Yeah, we'll
there
do it in
post. Okay.
Yes.
There it
oh,
is.
There we go.
God damn. Thank you. Hope you enjoyed the show today. For Rob Spiewak and Oscar Santana, Michael Bear saying so long, everybody. That's it. We got to go.
Bye-bye.
Ciao, ciao.
Before you go, please make a mental note. Today's show was made possible by the TMOS bonus packages. You can secure yours right now by going to MikeOMaraShow.com and clicking on the red bonus banner. Buy it or give it. Either way, you're helping out TMOS, and that's a good thing. Thank you, and go in peace.
Thank God it's Friday!
Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.
took me like 3 hours to finish the shading on your upper lip.
Ha ha, you fool! You fell victim to one of the classic blunders. The most famous is never get involved in a land war in Asia, but only slightly less well known is this. Never go in against a Sicilian when death is on the line.
Who dumped a whole truckload of fizzies into the swim meet? Who delivered the medical school cadavers to the alumni dinner? Every Halloween, the trees are filled with underwear. Every spring, the toilets explode.
You're talking about Delta, sir.
Yeah, boy!